President Biden, end Cuba's communist regime once and for all. As the communist Cuban government brutally suppresses protests in the streets, the American Society for the Defense of Tradition, Family, and Property, TFP, joins those who deplore Marxism in all its forms to demand an end to the country's communist dictatorship. The time has come to rally around the abandoned Cuban people that have suffered this oppression for 62 years. Thousands have been arrested in the current protests, many were killed, and hundreds are missing. The government censors communication with the outside world and even blocks the internet. At this critical hour, the judgment of God and history will be severe should the anguished cries of protesters be ignored. The communist oppression in Cuba must be eliminated once and for all. What keeps communist Cuba going? Even as the violence increases, the left worldwide rallies around the communist government and shamelessly blames America for the present suffering on the island. They claim Cuba suffers because of America's embargo that forbids trade with the regime. America generously exempts food and medication from its embargo. Moreover, nothing in the U.S. embargo stops Cuba from buying whatever it wants from other nations. Is it not ironic that Cuban communists blame the island's plight on the U.S. embargo of capitalist goods while working for 60 years to overthrow the capitalist system? Alas, the lifting of the trade embargo will not end, but only prolong the misery of the Cuban people. Blame for the crimes now playing out in Cuban streets must be placed upon those who directly and indirectly support this cruel regime. Direct support comes from nations hostile to America like Russia, China, Iran, and Venezuela. Cuba also relies on the West's rich, useful idiots who build infrastructure projects and make money off the blood, sweat, and tears of the enslaved Cuban people while living in the luxury of their townhouses and condos. The communist government sustains itself with tourist dollars that do not trickle down to the Cuban people. The regime counts on free publicity from the liberal macro-capitalist mass media that always presents the failed communist state in a positive light. Despite all this direct support, Cuba, once called the Pearl of the Antillas, remains immersed in misery. Communism never produced prosperity anywhere. Indirect support also props up the diabolical regime. More support comes from those who indirectly help the regime by taking up its cause. Take away this buttress and Cuban communism would collapse. Leftists the world over are unanimous in their enthusiasm for Cuba, seeing it as the last great hope of communism after the fall of the Soviet Empire. Liberals, socialists, and academics seem to gather courage from the fact that Cuba survives and defies the West. For this reason, groups like Black Lives Matter defend Cuba's repression of the protesters in the streets. They see Cuba's communist cause as their own. Shamelessly, leftist governments and media worldwide have kept up a charade for decades, pretending that Cuba is a free nation with superior education and medical systems. As Cubans die from COVID-19, deprived of proper healthcare, the left worldwide needs to stop this fraud and accept the truth. Cuba's vaunted healthcare system is a disaster. Communism is the reason for the poverty and misery of the Cuban people, and it must be denounced. The anguished cries of the Cuban people today are a rebuke to this leftist support for Cuban communism. Before God and history, they accuse the left of this complicity in the suffering and deaths of countless victims. Worst is the Catholic left's support. God and history will judge even more severely the inexplicable support Cuba's atheistic regime has received from the Catholic left. From the beginning of the revolution, the Castro tyrants could count on high ecclesiastics and liberation theologians to point to Cuba as an evangelical paradise on earth. Tragic statements like that of then Archbishop Agostino Casaroli in 1974, for example, who said that Cuban Catholics were happy under the socialist regime of Fidel Castro. Over the decades, leftist priests and nuns have made pilgrimages to Havana and treated the bloody Castro brothers as revolutionary saints. As Cubans die in the streets, Friar Beto, a Brazilian Dominican, defends the island prison as a paradise for the poor. This subversive religious further excuses the regime's repression, saying, "The resilience of the Cuban people, nourished by Martí, Che Guevara, and Fidel, has shown itself to be invincible." The church's sinister silence about the plight of the Cuban people is made more tragic by the support of Pope Francis, who visited Cuba and showed sympathy for its leaders. About the present violence, he said, "I pray that the Lord might help the nation construct a society that is more and more just and fraternal through peace, dialogue, and solidarity." He did not call for the end of communism. He did not call for the end of the brutal regime. Calls for peace, dialogue, and solidarity under a regime that is increasingly unjust and unfraternal demand from Catholics a position of respectful resistance. Long ago, Brazilian TFP founder Plínio Correa de Oliveira affirmed and explained the right of Catholics to resist the Holy See's policy of détente with communist regimes as a matter of conscience. Cardinal Ratzinger called communism the shame of our time. This shame must end once and for all. Appeal to President Biden. President Joseph Biden was recently forced to admit that communism is a failed system, a universally failed system, and I don't see socialism as a very useful substitute. The American TFP calls on the president to bring the failed system of communism to an end in Cuba. Let him have the courage to lead the world in denouncing this scandalous Soviet leftover that continues to oppress its people. Let him denounce the worldwide support network that keeps the Cuban people in misery. Cuba's problem is not the U.S. embargo, but the communist ideology and regime. This is the message coming from the protesters, many of whom are young. They do not want communism, but a freedom they never knew. Let us rid Cuba of communism once and for all. Cuba's communist ideology must be eradicated because it spreads like cancer beyond the island to other nations in the Western Hemisphere and around the globe. Communism is a far more deadly virus than COVID-19. Thus, the American TFP asks President Biden to adopt diligently all the measures needed to effect this regime change and the immediate normalization of life for the Cuban people. The Cuban communist must not be allowed to suffocate the legitimate desires of the Cuban people again. We are not afraid. At many protests, the people can be heard shouting, "We are not afraid!" Indeed, in face of the regime's brutality, the Cuban people will have nothing to fear if they place their trust in the powerful intercession and protection of the Virgin of Charity of Cobre, patroness of Cuba. May she give the Cuban people all the graces and virtue necessary to attain their long-awaited freedom.